Hello, I'm Darin Crapo, and welcome to this week's edition of UFO Planet. Tonight I have some awesome videos of aliens that have been recorded over the years, and I also have a fantastic video of a UFO on the moon shot by an astronomer using an Earth-based telescope. And of course, I have some of the latest UFO videos from around the planet. Let's get this show started right now. Welcome to episode 3 of UFO Planet. The topic of today's program is aliens caught on camera, and I have 4 video clips of that this morning, and they're going to show you some of the great footage that's been caught over the years. Now, the first clip is apparently some aliens that were captured after they crashed at Roswell, New Mexico, which begs me to wonder what went on there, because I was always under the assumption that the aliens that were in the Roswell crash were dead and unseen, but maybe that's different. Anyway, this video footage is apparently of aliens from the military in the 1950s. Now, I found this particular video online in several places, and each one of them had a different description, but the reason I wanted to play it for you today is to give you an idea of what some people think aliens look like. Now, if this is real, that's pretty fantastic. They look like what we would call the grays. Apparently there are 3 species of gray aliens that visit the Earth. Now, the next clip I have here today, I debated on whether or not I was going to show it to you. I wasn't sure it was worthy of airplay. This is a clip of some still photos that were taken with aliens that were apparently with the Nazis during World War II. Now, we've all heard those stories, so let's have a look at them here. Personally, I think that the photographs have been photoshopped, and they're absolutely not real at all. I find it very difficult to believe that the Nazis had assistance from aliens, and you can tell in that picture there that Hitler was looking well over the head of that alien, so it's something that's photoshopped. There's a lot of people around the world that have nothing better to do and think if they photoshop an alien with Hitler that everyone's gonna believe it. The only thing everyone believes is that they have too much time on their hands. Okay, now the next clip we have is a little bit, if you're a little bit queasy, you might not like this one. This is a clip of aliens in a mortuary. Now let's just get that going here. When I first looked at this clip, I thought that these bodies looked an awful lot like the bodies that tour around in the Body Worlds exhibit. I saw that in Salt Lake City, Utah last year, and the bodies had the same coloring once they were plasticized. But then if you look closely here, you look at the toes, you look at the fingers, you look at the size of the head, the eyeballs. The other thing I thought about is I was a firefighter for 10 years, and I can tell you the bodies usually don't look this good if they've been in a traumatic crash. At least the human body doesn't look that good. Maybe they're built a little bit better. I also thought perhaps this could be a clip that was made for a Hollywood production and accidentally got put on the internet and everyone's believing that it's real. I have no idea. If it is real, it's pretty awesome. That's some great footage of aliens in a mortuary, and obviously they're all deceased. It looks like a fairly large room. I didn't know they had mortuaries that large, but apparently they do somewhere. And that was an interesting video. Like I said, you have to take everything I show you with a grain of salt, because I have absolutely no way of verifying these videos. I simply present them to you to let you decide in your mind what you think is real. Now, the next video I think is real. It is a video of a military man. He's an ex-military Air Force man from the United States, and he's going to explain a little bit about what the UFO program was like down in the Americas. Now, I want to mention as well that I searched far and wide and was unable to find this gentleman's name. so I apologize for that, but it still plays very well and it has some great information, so let's go ahead and listen to that right now.
The reason I state that, when I got out in 1989, we had cataloged 57 different species. You have individuals that look very much like you and myself that could walk among us and you wouldn't even notice the difference, except for some of the things that they might be able to go ahead, even in a dark room, and touch an object and go ahead and identify what color that object might be. They would have a heightened sense of smell, sight, hearing. The situation is that you have various types of what we normally call grays. We didn't call them grays in the military, but you had at least three types of the grays. You had some that were much taller than we were. The unique thing that I'd like to point out for the most part is that the entities that we did catalog were in fact humanoid. Now this created a situation where the scientific community was trying to figure out why that would be the case, because you would expect that if life evolved on other planets, that they would take on some type of other being, so to speak, not necessarily look humanoid or be bipedal such as we are. But apparently, we got quite a few of the species out there that are humanoid in appearance, and that creates a question that yet has to be answered.
Now, I don't know about you, but I found that video to be absolutely fascinating. It was the first time I viewed it this week when I was doing research for the program, and I looked at that a few times, and I thought that was pretty fascinating. I just want to mention that I also added the clips of the alien beings in there. That was not in the original video, but it would play well on the television show today. And the one thing that I thought was interesting from his discussion there is he said that there were 57 species that they have cataloged. 57 species, think about that. That's a lot of visits to Earth to be able to catalog that many species. And that there's also three species of grays. The other thing that intrigued me very much is he said that they could be walking amongst us because they look just like us. Some of them are humanoid, which kind of means that your neighbor could be from out of this world. That's kind of interesting. Let's just hope she's a good-looking girl if she is. Okay, let's move ahead here before we get in trouble. Our next video today is from a gentleman named Alberto Mayer, and Alberto is from Italy, and he took some imagery of the moon, of a UFO transversing the moon with his telescope in his backyard connected to a video camera. Now, when you look at this video clip, I want you to look at the bottom portion of your screen because that's where the video, or where the UFO rather, is going to appear. So let's look at Alberto's video. Now, you can see the UFO transversing the bottom portion of your screen there. And I found this video to be quite fascinating. How often do you get to catch something like this? Now, I've received several emails from viewers concerning the previous episodes where we spoke about UFOs on the moon, and the explanation that I got from the viewers was, well, those are just probes that you're seeing. Well, the probes change direction. Are probes that huge? I don't think so. So you're going to have to come up with a better explanation for this one. I thought that was fantastic. April 29th, 2007 in Busto, Italy. And again, that was Alberto Mayer. That was a fantastic video. When I saw that for the first time this week as well, I thought this is awesome because this may be the proof that some people are looking for, that there are UFOs that do visit the moon. As I mentioned in a previous episode, some people believe they actually have a base on the far side of the moon that we're unable to see. Now, I really don't know if that's true or not, and we haven't had the Chinese and the Russians and then the Americans come out and say, hey, yeah, we found that when we mapped the moon. Nothing's been said. So let's move ahead, and our next video tonight is from West Glacier National Park down in the United States of America. This is a fantastic video because this is the kind of video that was shot, and he captured a video or a UFO, but he was actually trying to videotape a bird. So when you look at this video, you're going to want to look in the top right hand corner of your screen. This videographer is going to follow a bird across the road up the side of a mountain, and then a UFO is going to go zipping by. So let's have a look at this one right now. Now you can see the bird just kind of crossing the road there. It's not a very large, pardon me, I should say highway. And it goes up to the side of the mountain. Now here's where the UFO comes into the picture. Did you catch that? It just went zipping by. Now this was an excellent video because this guy, not only was it a nice clear video compared to many, he actually took and did a slow motion and a replay, which is pretty awesome. It's nice to see some people out there know how to run their editors. And there you can see, now I couldn't tell, does that UFO actually go through the cloud initially in the small version? It kind of looks like it did, but this here, it looks kind of like it's in front of the cloud. It's kind of really hard to tell. What do you think? Now from the distance, you take a look at that bird in the mountain, and that UFO is going to be a lot further in the distance. So that UFO has the potential of being very enormous. Like I said, that's one of my favorite kinds of UFO videos because they were unplanned. Now, the next video, we're going to go to Rutlingen, Germany. And I'm sorry if I butchered that name. I have no idea how to pronounce it. And this was shot on June 9th, 2012. And this is going to be a photo of, or a video clip of three dots up in the sky that form a triangular formation. So let's go ahead and have a look at that. Now, the triangular formation has seemingly become very popular in ufology. And because of a lot of sightings of triangular-shaped craft a few years back in the United States specifically. Now, my personal opinion on that is that they were actually sighting the stealth aircraft that the Americans were developing secretly and only flying at night. And some people happened to catch a glimpse of those, and that was before the public knew. Now, the unfortunate thing in this video we're watching is watch how these lights just simply fade away. Right away, that took away all the credibility on that video, in my opinion, because it became very apparent that that was a simple elementary editing job on a video editor. He simply placed three dots on the screen and then faded them away and overlaid them over top of a little bit of a video screaming out to the sky. So I don't understand people's motives behind that. What would motivate them to doing that? Do they appreciate being deceived? I don't understand that. Never will, I guess. So we need to move along here. We only have about 2.5 minutes left in today's program. Our next video, I'm going to take you to Moscow. And in this video, you're going to see the same UFO twice, early in the evening and then later in the evening. And let's go ahead and look at that. Again, this is from Moscow, Russia on April 9th, 2012. You can just catch a glimpse of that UFO hovering near that apartment complex. Now get a load of the lights on that UFO because you're going to be able to compare them to what we look at here in a little bit and see that they're the same. And that UFO is just slightly moving. It's not moving all that fast at all, so it's not like it's a jet aircraft. Now take a look at that dot that appeared up there in the sky, the light heading towards the UFO that disappears. Very interesting. Now this is later in the night with the UFO over top of Moscow. Very interesting. These types of videos fascinate me because although they're not totally explained, they're not unexplainable. Now, take a look at this. This was the zoom shot, and I took and I slowed down this videographer's zoom shot to 30% of normal so you could see the lighting. It looked very similar to what you saw by the apartment complex, which kind of technically verifies that it's possibly the same craft. And that, to me, is just fascinating. You can kind of see a shape to that craft, and it is absolutely incredible footage. Whoever shot that, fantastic job. Again, that was over Moscow, Russia in April 9th. Well, that's all the time we have today. You'll notice that I've implemented some of the changes in the program that have been suggested on YouTube. And I just want to thank you all for tuning in each week. We're going to have a new program posted online on Sunday evenings at 9:30 p.m. with the eventuality of going live with our broadcast. So thanks a lot for joining me, and I'll see you again next week.